Hi there, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to make a really nice and awesome 3-liter underwater breathing device that will give you up to 15 full breaths, which adds up to around 1 or 2 minutes, or 5 minutes if you're an experienced freediver underwater. Although 2 or 5 minutes doesn't sound like much, but when compared to taking 1 breath and doing half a minute underwater, is a lot. And since my last device got over 15,000 views, I think it's time to upgrade. So I'm Darren, and I'm your host, and you're watching Darren DIY. And now, without any further ado, grab a drink or something to eat, and I hope you will enjoy. So these are all the items needed to make the underwater breathing device. I am not going to say them one by one because it would take me forever, and I changed some of them further in the video. But I have them in the video description down below if you want to make such device. So now let's start. First, grab two large plastic bottles. I chose 1.5 liter ones. You could either choose 1 or 2 or 2.5 liters. Then grab their caps and drill an 11mm hole in the middle of them. After this, remove any plastic pieces remaining on the edge of the holes. Now, grab the two plastic bottles and drill an 11mm hole in the middle of the bottom of the bottles. After you have drilled the holes, make sure to also remove any plastic pieces remaining on the edge of the holes, or else the tire valves won't make a good seal and you'll have an air leak. Now grab three of the valves and using a 4mm drill bit, drill the mechanism from the valves so that it is hollow. After this, grab two of the hollowed out valves and lubricate them with some non-toxic oil. Now insert the caps into the tire valves like this, and then clamp one valve in a vise and pull on the cap until it is inserted completely and the valve makes an airtight seal with the cap. After this, repeat the process with the other hollow valve and cap. Now you should have two valves left, one hollow and the other normal. So grab them and lubricate them with some oil, as we did before. And grab a piece of firm steel wire and put one of the valves on the wire. And insert the valve into the hole of the bottle, like this. Then clamp the valve in a vise and pull on the bottle until the valve is in place and makes an airtight seal. After this, repeat the process with the other valve and bottle. Now, we can go ahead and screw the caps to the bottles. And after that, you should have something like this. Now, I went ahead and cut some pieces of Velcro, so that the bottles stay together. So now, lubricate once again the valves in the caps, and then cut a piece of tubing, roughly 10 to 15 centimeters, and insert two hose clamps in it. After this, insert the tubing into the two valves as much as you could, and then tighten the hose clamps on the tubing on the tire valves. So after all of that, it should look something like this. Now let us put everything aside and start working on the valve part. So first of all, if you could get a regulator in the first place, it would be a lot better and safer than a valve, since you could regulate the amount of air precisely and you don't have the risk of letting the air all out at once. I chose the valve because it was a heck a lot cheaper, and so to make this device as cheap as possible. So first, grab your valve and insert a rubber washer into both sides of the valve. Then, grab your hose barbs, which are these hose to valve adapters, and wrap the threaded part with 3 layers of Teflon plumbing tape. After this, thread the hose barbs into the valve with the help of a vise or a pair of pliers. And now you should have something like this. So let us put it to the side and bring back the bottles. So on the bottom of the bottles you should have 2 valves, one normal and the other hollowed out. So once again, let us lubricate the valve which is hollowed out, then insert a long piece of tubing on the valve. And after that, secure the hose using a hose clamp. And as you can see here, I have cut some pieces of Velcro so that I can strap the bottles to my back. But I house this device in a small backpack, which I'll show you further in the video. And now, we are almost finished, and all that is left to do is to hook up the hose to the valve part using a hose clamp. It doesn't matter which way. And then, hook up a piece of tubing onto the other side of the valve. I also glued a piece of Velcro onto the base of my valve, so that I can hook it to a piece of Velcro on my backpack. And just like that, our build is complete. And now, if you want, you could give it a spray paint. And I chose to paint it black as that would make it look cool. So as you can see, if you spray paint it, it should look something like this. And now, for the final thing, I went ahead and put the underwater breathing device in a small backpack, as it made it nicer and more compact. So now that it is ready, let me show you how to put it on, then do a dry test, and then do the final and most important test, a test at the beach. So to put it on is really simple. If you have the Velcro, it's just a matter of locking it around your waist, and you're ready to go. And if you put it in a backpack like mine, it's a matter of putting it on you and then tightening the buckles. And now, let's do a dry test. So to inflate this, there are a lot of pumps to choose from. But the best one that I found was this large hand pump that you could hold onto with your feet. So now let's hook this up to our device and start inflating. So the reason that I found this pump to be the best is that you don't need too much power and time to reach 60 or 80 psi, which is the maximum pressure that the system can handle, by the way. So now let's test it. And as you saw, from that I got 12 breaths. So now let's go to the beach and test it. So as you saw, it works, but there is a major flaw. As you might have seen, to stay underwater I had to latch onto the ladder, because I forgot a very important thing. Since there is air in the bottles, they are becoming buoyant. And so, we need weights to overcome that force. Around 5 to 7 kilograms should do it. So then, a day later, I went again to the beach with some small bricks as weights. And it worked, but it wasn't perfect as the bricks were slipping out of my shirt. So I came up with an idea. I wrapped some Velcro around the bricks and wrapped another piece of Velcro around my waist and attached the bricks to my waist with the Velcro, and it was ready to go. At the end, I was pretty satisfied with the results, as you could enjoy the scene for 5 or 2 more minutes, with only a cost of about 15 euros. So if you do want to make this, remember that all of the items needed are listed down below. And I really hope that you have lots of fun making it. But you want to make sure that you stay safe down there, because I don't want to be the cause of some death. Also make sure to tell me down below. So after a long process of filming and editing, I really hope that you have enjoyed this video, or at least appreciate the time needed for this video to be possible. So if you did, please drop a like down below, it would really help me. And subscribe so that you won't miss any new videos like this one. And also don't forget to share this video with your friends if you think it's awesome. So now, I'll leave you this footage of this underwater breathing device at work. And as always, stay safe and have fun. I'll see you in the next one. Bye bye. Oh.